To begin with, I would like to explain a couple of moments about this video. First, English isn't my mother tongue, and my speaking skill isn't really good. Therefore, as long as I don't want to tire you with a long word selection and phrases construction, I have to write what I want to say before and then learn it by heart. Nevertheless, from time to time I would be compelled to take a glance into my speech sheet. Hope it doesn't sound like shit. Secondly, I know that my accent could sound unpleasant for native English speakers. So if it does, please don't hesitate to let me know about it in the comments. And I'll try to make the next video in some other way. The final moment. This video is my first ever attempt to make a photography tutorial. Well, actually not a tutorial. Let's call it photography explaining video. So if you like it, please, again, let me know about it in the comments. And I will make the second and then the third part. So let's start. Have you ever thought that we people are quite paradoxical creatures? I can give you many different examples, but as long as we talk about photography, the landscape one predominantly, let's take exactly it. On the one hand, we always look for some kind of order, system in the chaos of the world. And that's why landscape photographs by beginners have less recognition and praise. They simply couldn't put in order things they see around. But on the other hand, the excess of an order doesn't look good for us either. Take for instance a view of rectangular boxes of high-rise buildings in some sleeping quarters. For a viewer, it looks like a dull plenty of squares, boring and ugly. Here, any nature lover could object that nature isn't the chaos, but the special and complicated order. I agree. Moreover, it would be weird for me to argue, since I know such concepts like golden ratio, normal distribution and Fibonacci spiral. But there is exactly the first obstacle for any beginner in landscape photography. Learn how to see, to notice that special order in the world around and fit it in the frame harmonically. But I run ahead of the locomotive. What are the traps for any beginner in landscape photography? About the pitfalls for amateur and advanced photographers, we will talk later in the second and the third part of this video respectively. If you don't want to miss it, subscribe to my channel and press the bell. Please subscribe to my channel and press the bell. Press the bell. Trap number one for any beginner photographer is the purchase of his first serious camera. I mean DSLR or mirrorless or even super zoom compact camera. Any camera that has different modes, separate lens, unlike smartphones. After buying your first camera, you may probably thought that now all your photographs automatically become masterpieces. Because you have different modes of shooting, shallow depth of field, the ability of slow shutter speed, and finally its price. That's an illusion. Yes, your photographs of flower buds look more interesting because of blurring the background made by your lens. And yet this bracing feeling of really creative and pricey tool in your hand. But if you are evolving as a person in general, and a photographer in particular, very soon you start realizing that all the technical stuff that you have already doesn't make your photographs outstanding. To be honest, their usual photos look similar to the thousands of other photographs that are flooding internet. That's my cat. She's Penelope. Trap number two for beginners in landscape photography is the assurance that the only thing you have to do is to get to some famous picturesque place like Grand Canyon, Dolomite Alps, Kamchatka Peninsula, etc. You might think that you only have to get there to take an amazing shot. That's an illusion as well. Of course, there's some difference between places of the world, and it's way easier to take a good shot when you are at, say, Torres del Paine, comparing to mostly boring-looking landscapes of south of Leningrad region, area where I live. But still, you should clearly understand one simple thing. Photography, in fact, is the drawing with light. That means that the most beautiful place in the world will look ordinary and straightforward if you don't know how and, the most important, when to take a shot. And the opposite, you may take absolutely stunning image of some ordinary place if you photograph at the right moment with the beautiful light. Nevertheless, that doesn't mean you shouldn't travel. When we would die in our warm and cozy bed, we would recall not a car we drove, not a smartphone we use, not a huge flat TV we had. We would recollect the brightest emotions, the most substantial feelings we felt. We would remember our parents' love, our first kiss, our wedding, the birth of our children, and of course, the most beautiful places we visited. So traveling is one of the most important activities for a modern human. But when you photograph somewhere close to a place where you live, you have much more chances to take a good shot, great shot. Just because you know good spots and you had the opportunity to get there quickly and catch the best light. Seeing it in some unfamiliar place, it's mostly the question of luck. So what to do? How to get to the next level? Firstly, give yourself an answer for a couple of simple questions. Are you really interested in photography? Are you sure you want to develop and grow? If yes, I can give you some advice, if you don't mind, of course. First, learn the manual instruction of your camera. You'll wonder how many useful information is there. But don't read it as a novel. Just ask yourself how, for example, to shoot a creek the way it looks on the photograph, like a smooth ribbon. Yes, you should use the time priority mode. How to turn it on? How to use it properly? What necessary gear you need to make a good shot? Read the instructions. Second, train your eye. That means learn works of great masters of photography and painting. That not only give you an understanding of what is good and what isn't, but also provides you with the knowledge what is new. Third, learn the photography lessons. No matter it is paid courses or free lessons on YouTube, what matters is who the author. Find a good photographer whose works you really like and take her or his classes. Fourth, don't stop photographing. Theory and knowledge are tremendous, but are useless unless you apply them while shooting. Practice is probably the most crucial part of photography. Finally, fifth, photograph where you live. Learn your home area, find good spots for photography, and plan your shooting considering weather, season, and time of the day. Well, I guess that's it for now. See you in the next part.